August 14th, 2012, from the SS Independence. This is Rann 109 and Rann's Picker's Paradise. Let's see what I've got here this week. Again, I'm fighting rain. I swear, every time there's fire danger, I should just threaten to make videos, and then we'll just have all kinds of rain. First item. The wife and I are planning on getting an Xbox 360, so this just saved us a buttload of money. Many of the games we wanted anyway. $2 each. Any of you familiar with these games know what you're looking at here. And I was skeptical about these at first, but they're hairbrushes and combs with handles that extend, that you can extend them out a couple of feet for handicapped people, and I found out they're fairly expensive when you buy them new. They're all sealed, never used. Even comes with a spoon. So I was happy about that when I got home. There were a couple other things I got that kind of came with the deal that I'm not even showing because I'm not too thrilled about it, but I got it for practically nothing, so that's all right. Here's another thing in that, a couple of blood pressure checkers. I can't even pronounce the name. Even though I use one, I can't pronounce the name. But so I guess I'll sell those. One of them's brand new, and the other one's used. A couple of fuel bottles for your white gasoline for your camp stoves and lanterns. I like this little thing, a wall pocket that has an old post office box door. That ought to be good. All this was dirt cheap. It was a storage unit sale, not an auction, but the people that own the storage units just wanted to be rid of the stuff. They didn't want to go to the trouble of having an auction. There's one of those newer kind of hobo type camp knives. It's got a knife, one side, a fork, they slide out. I've actually got another one that I've used and I like it. Big heavy duty stapler. I was happy to find these, a couple of brand new Gerber leather basket weave belt sheaths, never used. A Gillette razor with antique razor blades, still in the packages. And a bike bag that was wrapped in an old jacket that the people didn't even know they had there, that had these tools in it. Combination tool for bicycles and tire repair, stuff like that. And a cell phone holder, kind of made here locally by a guy. This one's on the back, but a couple of tools. I'm always looking for good C-clamps because I use them a lot in repairing furniture and building furniture and stuff. An old American-made wrench, slip joint wrench there. And two digital camouflage mole, however you pronounce that, fanny packs. One of them's used, the other one's brand new. And another military issue belt pouch of some kind. A camelback. I've been meaning to get one of these. Luckily this one didn't come with the water bladder in it. I'm always leery about using a bottle or anything someone else has drank out of, so I'll just get one of those, and it's already worn in places, so I won't have to worry about, feel guilty about keeping it or feel bad about putting the first rip in it when I do it. And an Eddie Bauer insulated lunch sack. Arizona Cardinal kind of sweat towel. A nice nylon belt. And let's see. A couple of grocery list, magnetic grocery list tablets for the refrigerator. So yeah, pretty good little haul. I think I'll make back the cost of everything with just these brushes here. And So, well, I wrapped that up in a hurry. And my mascot kitty isn't around, so this is Rann109 signing out. I always forget something. If you're a mechanic, or you've worked anywhere in the trades using hand tools, you know the name Snap-on. This is a magnetic caster camber gauge. Got two of them, $5 each. And I can get them, I can sell them, I believe, for about $50 or $60 each, maybe more. I don't know much about them, but I know the name. And I know if you've got Snap-on tools, you've paid a lot for them, but they're about the only tool you'll ever have to buy because you can't wear them out, and they have a lifetime guarantee. So yeah, I was thrilled to find these.